afternoon, good night, wherever you're watching this from. Welcome to Assemblyline. This is Assem Sports on this bright, beautiful, hot, very hot summer Saturday. Summer is a season in space where the international tournaments take place. Summer is when the Olympics go down. Finally, the opening ceremony. The opening ceremony went down yesterday in Paris. It was an exhibition of French culture, French history, French artistry. A very bold opening ceremony where they decided to carry football, soccer, but also sports fans across the streets of Paris to exhibit the heritage, the history, the culture, but most importantly, the artistry. And they were able to paint a timeline of the French history, the different stages in which their country, their nation, have evolved over the years. One of the best opening ceremonies, if you ask me. I've watched several opening ceremonies, but there has been none like this. Marie Antoinette, ladies and gentlemen, Marie Antoinette was the tagline across social media. Zinedine Zidane, the great, made an appearance. And if you measure it to opening ceremonies, there has never been one like that. The French artistry has always been a visionaries, and they exhibited it across the globe. It was really fun to watch. The Olympics is off to a great start. Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. The football soccer games, similar to Olympic regular tradition, started a day before the opening ceremony. Raining, it was raining all day in Paris during the opening ceremony. Some people say that is a symbolism for the state of affairs, the nature in which the French institution, but also the French government, the political aspect of it, the fact that it was raining all throughout, but also it might be showers of blessing if you choose to be looking at things from an optimistic point of view. Zinedine Zidane's appearance really made it great. But the security of the Olympics has also become the topic. If you were listening to the news yesterday, the train stations in Paris were locked down because certain people, certain parties organized to tamper with the technicalities of the Paris train system. It is still shut down. So the Olympics, the sport is going great, but the security that comes along with it has been called to repute. And if you watch the game between Argentina and Morocco, where fans were able to invade the pitch. So there's a lot going on in the world right now politically. There's no room for politics in football and sports, but for some reason, it always finds its way in there. Trains in Paris have been shut down since the Olympics started. People are congested on the subway. Fans are finding it difficult to travel across board. And the security has become real concern if they are going to be able to handle the rigorous nature of all these people traveling to Paris. Are they equipped enough to handle it? Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. The Olympic is off to a great start this morning. Tennis happened. The football has already begun. Djokovic and Carlos Alcaraz have already won their first games. There's the appetizing, mouth-watering class of doubles where Rafael Nadal is going to be playing with Carlos Alcaraz. Most sports fans, not just tennis fans, are looking forward to the Alcaraz Nadal double clash. Andy Murray is in there, Novak is in there. So yes, it's a lot going on in the Olympics. The US contingent was represented by LeBron James and I think Noah Miles, the track and field one. So yes, the Olympics is going down, but I think that is not enough. Summer games are going on in the USA, where today Chelsea is going to be in action against Celtic. Manchester United is going to be playing against Arsenal. And the conversation around Chelsea is Enzo Fernandez. If you saw a clip of Enzo Fernandez, I think it was after the Copa America, he was singing racist chant songs with his Argentinian teammates, his domestic club teammates, Chelsea, who are from France, took offense to it. It's the whole thing. The new Chelsea coach, Enzo Maresku, was asked about it. And in an interview, he said something like they've already talked about it. But there's a lot going on with Chelsea. They played a 2-2 draw with Wrexham, a League 3 English side. And if the Chelsea reserves, it is quite alarming if the Chelsea reserve squad can't beat Wrexham. They are playing today against Celtic. Manchester United also having troubles with Erik ten Hag. They acquired more Dutch players. In an interview, he really made people question the ambition behind this Manchester United team. If Carabao Cup and the FA Cup trophy is what they are so proud of, they finished 8th in the Premier League, but it doesn't look like the Manchester new board are concerned. They would rather win Community Shields and the FA Cups than finishing top four. I mean, it's a very weird time we are living in with this Manchester United team and Chelsea. Enzo Maresku is playing today against Celtic, and Manchester United is playing against Arsenal. I think Man City is playing AC Milan. Lots of teams are in the USA. Liverpool yesterday beat Real Betis 1-0. Not convincing, but like I said, all of the teams are trying to get their squad in shape. It's going to be lots of the young kids from the academy, just like trying out to see what they would have as a reserve squad if the main guys are not able to play. Mo Salah played. He gave a good assist to Szoboszlai. He got a goal, but all in all, Real Betis is not really strong opposition. I mean, I expected Liverpool to win that. So yes, it's a lot going on. Let me know what you think about the Olympics so far. Let me know what you think about the summer games that is going on. Chelsea played 2-2 with Wrexham today. They are playing against Celtic tonight. Manchester United is also playing against Arsenal. Like you already know, the forecast 1.0. New Assam Music Collection available on all platforms. Click the link in the bio. This is Assam Sports. What is coming soon? New music loading. Have a wonderful weekend. Goodbye, Uncle.